football is just a few weeks away. Spring weather, not necessarily that close in Minnesota, but we're talking Golden Gophers football with Daniel House on the line from Score North and Gopher Hole. And again, Minnesota culminating with 11-2 and a big bowl win against Auburn, trying to keep up the momentum. They certainly did so during the recruiting efforts. And now we look ahead to spring football. Of course, Daniel on the offensive side of the ball, it begins with Tanner Morgan. He's back in play, but a lot of productivity lost in the ground game at running back with a lot of experience there from the past few years, and at wide receiver, some of the best wide receiver talent we've seen at Minnesota in decades. Your preview as we look ahead to the spring on offense.
The offense has a lot of returning talent coming back. I mean, really, when you break it all down, Rodney Smith and Tyler Johnson are the biggest losses. Of course, two really big players for this team. But I look at Muhammad Ibrahim being able to step into that role as the primary back. Then they have Cam Wiley, Trey Potts, both developing behind the scenes. And then Kai Thomas, as we talked about earlier, being a guy that can come in and become a dynamic playmaker in the offense. We'll see how much he's involved. But the biggest thing for me with this offense is going to be who fills Tyler Johnson's role. We know that everyone's going to bracket cover Rashad Bateman. He was already even getting it with Tyler Johnson in the fold. Those two kind of worked hand in hand together. So who steps up in that role? I believe Chris Autman-Bell will improve and continue to get better. He's been kind of the dynamic playmaker in the red zone, a very physical catch guy and contested catch situations. But I'm looking for the guy that can maybe step in and be the dynamic complementary option to Rashad Bateman. Name to keep an eye on is Douglas Emelian from Florida. He turned down offers from LSU and Miami to come to Minnesota. Heard a lot of good things about him. Very, very dynamic with the ball in his hands. They gave him a lot of passes like screens and quick stuff over the middle, and he was just very, very electric with the ball in his hands. So if he can emerge, maybe Daniel Jackson from Kansas. But overall, I see the offensive line returning, all five guys coming back again, continue to add more guys in this last recruiting class that will be developing, like Ariante Ursary, Martis Lewis. But you see that all coming back, and then everyone kind of forgets about Tanner Morgan, the quarterback. Really underrated season from him. When you look at all the efficiency metrics, like EPA per dropback, I looked at Joe Burrow, Tua, Jalen Hurts, Morgan, Fields. Morgan ranks fourth among those quarterbacks. Trevor Lawrence was sixth. So you can really see that the Gophers have one of the top returning quarterbacks next season. So a lot of momentum going on offensively. But the big question is, how does that fit together? And with a new offensive coordinator coming in, Mike Sanford Jr. from Utah State, he's going to be taking co-offensive coordinator duties with Matt Simon, who called plays during the bowl game. I liked how he did that. He was really aggressive in some situations, went for it three times on fourth down, really used the tight end, was creative in the red zone. The biggest difference I think everyone is going to notice with Mike Sanford is, one, he's going to really involve the tight ends, which is something that Gopher fans get really excited about. They really want to see that, and Kirk Schrock had never really utilized that at Minnesota. And then not only that, but the vertical passing game, adding some concepts, some wrinkles that really stretch the field. More drop back passing, maybe some boot stuff, taking advantage of trying to stretch the field out. I believe there's a lot of opportunity with this offense to maybe pass the ball on first down. I'm a huge proponent of passing to set up the run. And when you go back and look at Mike Sanford's trends on first down, he's about a 50-50 pass rate guy on first down. So he obviously understands the importance of play sequences. Pass, run, run is one of the best play sequences that you can have for efficiency. So I would expect that first down passing offense, and then not only that, but the vertical passing concepts are going to be melded in to what they've already done offensively, which is some really efficient football.
As you mentioned, Rodney Smith takes his 1,163 yards, 8 touchdowns with him to the next level. And again, Tyler Johnson, the most prolific receiver in the history of the program, 86 catches, 13 touchdowns. But as you mentioned as well, with Autman-Bell and 28 catches, 5 touchdowns. It'll be interesting to see his productivity go way up as we check out a Gopher offense where we've also in the past during those good Minnesota teens under Glenn Mason seen the two running backs that are extremely Barber and Maroney in particular, but the depth at running back better than it's ever been, and at wide receiver certainly as well. When we look at the defense, I see where Antoine Winfield obviously had one of the great years in the secondary across college football with 7 interceptions, led the team in tackles. He's had some injury issues. I see where he's listed as coming back. Is that correct, even though he's had 4 years on the field, or is he gone?
Antoine Winfield declared for the draft. So he's going to be very coveted. You're starting to see a lot of draft buzz from him. Many people are talking like he could be a top 50 pick, maybe inch into the first round. Mel Kiper's first mock draft today, he had Winfield going to the Vikings at 25 in the first round. So that's really intriguing, following in his father's footsteps, if that really happened. But yeah, replacing him is the single biggest factor heading into 2020 because of his versatility, the ability to just have those natural instincts, the leadership. He's a ball hawk, and his versatility changed the entire defense. Teams had to scheme specifically for him. So Tyler Newbin, last year's class, really was a highlight with Newbin in it. And his versatility, athleticism, they're going to really be relying on him to step up and develop. He worked a little bit on special teams, but being a guy that was one of the top players in the 2019 class from Illinois, Newbin is going to be one of the guys that's asked to step up in a big way.